Public Affairs Committee PAC has said they have picked the color red to be used for the planned December 13 demonstrations to push for the tabling of the Electoral Reforms Bills, which include adoption of a 50-plus zone system of choosing the country's president to enhance credibility. Some citizens will march on December 13 waving red cards, the football penalty symbol for expulsion. However, he influential multifaith quasi-religious human rights, democracy and accountability watcog has disclosed that the protests will not only focus on electoral reforms but various issues bordering on transformative leadership. PAC Executive Director, Robert Peary, has said they will also present a petition to government expressing its position on the current state of affairs. The main message will still focus on reform. However, placards will reflect on various issues bordering on transformational leadership as a gap, given that commitments made by the country's leadership will not have been met by December 13, 2017, Peary said. We have identified the color red as that to be worn on this particular day by the marchers. He said those who do not have red colors will still take part. Over 60 civil society CSOs are said to back the protests and some citizens will march waving red cards, the football penalty symbol for expulsion to undemocratic tendencies. PAC boss clearly stated that the protesters are not driven by political ends but the common good. The governing Democratic Progressive Party DPP has been spreading propaganda that the protests are influenced by the opposition for their own political gains. But Peary said, no political party can influence PAC. Peary indicated that the PAC board had agreed to proposals to have the marches held in all the country's 28 districts. The body had initially announced that the marches would only take place in Blantyre, Lilongwe, Mzuzu and Zomba. He also said the matter was not only about the electoral reforms, but the inclusion of 50% plus zone as it was one of the benchmarks. Said Peary, we are looking at reforms as a package. Government has since circulated 3 out of 6 bills for the electoral reforms. The 3 are Electoral Commission Act Amendment Bill, Assumption of the Office of President Transitional Arrangement and Referendum Bill. The Law Commission recommended the following bills collectively called Electoral Reforms Bills: Constitution Amendment, Electoral Commission Amendment, Presidential and Parliamentary Elections Act PPEA and Local Government Elections Act, Assumption of the Office of President Transitional Arrangement and Referendum. The most contentious of the bills relate to the amendment of Section 82 of the Constitution and Section 96(5) of the PPE Act to provide for a change of the electoral system from a simple majority to a majority of more than 50% in the presidential race. The Electoral Commission Amendment Bill is proposed by the Special Law Commission recommends the enactment of the Elections Management Fund to ensure Malawi Electoral Commission MEC is financially autonomous. It also proposes changes in the appointment of the MEC chairperson as well as composition of the commissioners. The referendum bill, on the other hand, aims to introduce legislation on how to conduct a referendum as one does not exist currently. Follow and subscribe Nyaso TV. Please share this article if you like. Email this post.